Steve Lydeamore this morning from Immuron. Steve, good to see you. Good morning.
Yes, good morning, Andrew.
Yeah, look, big milestone you've announced here, record monthly sales in August for Travelan. Tell us a bit more, what was driving the numbers here?
Look, it's a combination of a couple of things, both good and bad. I mean, the bad was that we were out of stock for, just under 3 months. And the good news is during that period of time, we continued with sales and marketing efforts, which generated backorder sales that we've now been able to fulfill. But that's not the whole story. Australian sales in August were a record, very huge percentage number in comparison to last comparative period in August 2022. But that was only because in 2022 we had some supply chain issues. So I wouldn't look at that. But what I would look at is that August sales of Travelan in August were in excess of the total sales of Travelan in Australia in last financial year, which is quite impressive. So things are definitely on the up. People are traveling again. In the announcement I've just made, I noted that travel's up 48% on last year and getting closer to that pre-pandemic level. So we're just 11% shy of what it was back in 2019. And it was definitely on an upwards growth trajectory. And as you would imagine, as people travel, there's more needs for Travelan, the key product that people rely on for reducing the occurrence of traveler's diarrhea.
And of course, Steve, a recent development here, Travelan now available on the, is it the Amazon platform?
Yes, it is. It has been available on Amazon before, but not directly by Immuron. So we used to sell it via a distributor. We made the decision with the growth objectives in mind to bring that back in-house and open up our own shopfront. That gives you control over, sales and marketing efforts and pricing and those good things. And we've hit the ground running. We've done very well. And in August, sales on Amazon actually exceeded sales to our largest business customer, Passport Health. So good signs for growth ahead.
And so, well, exactly, just on that. So this momentum here behind growth and sales, you can see that continuing.
Yes, absolutely. I have to caution people, and that's why I noted that a lot of the Australian sales were backorders. So you won't see $1 million a month, at least not in the short term in Australia. But you will see replenishment demand. We've got strong demand from retail pharmacies in Australia, and Amazon sales in the US are expected to continue to grow, that's a good thing for the brand going forward.
Well, look, Steve, just while I've got you, I understand next month you'll be in Los Angeles at the LD Micro Conference. You'll be giving a presentation. What can we expect you to say, and what can we expect to hear out of it?
No doubt I'll talk about the sales growth of Travelan, but in that conference, people are also interested in our clinical programs, and we have Travelan in collaboration with two different parts of the US Department of Defense. There's a phase two study underway in Baltimore, Maryland. It's a controlled human infection model study. Target number of subjects, healthy volunteers, is 60, and we've completed dosing 30 of those. So we're halfway through that trial, so I'll provide an update on that as of the status at the time of that particular meeting. And the other trial is the Uniformed Services University. It's conducting a field study in active US and UK military personnel. Placebo-controlled, pharma-quality, randomised controlled trial. Of those 868 subjects, I'll be able to provide an update as to how many we've recruited. Last report was about 40%. I expect it to be a high by the date of that meeting.
I suppose just for those not familiar, when it comes to treating gastrointestinal issues, what's the competition like? What's the opportunity for Travelan in the space?
Yeah, it's interesting. Our biggest challenge is not competition, direct competition anyway, for our particular product. It's improving our sales and marketing efforts to make people aware that the product exists, that there's a preventative treatment option rather than current. Traditionally, people take products with them to solve the issue after it's occurred. So oral rehydration salts, loperamide, the generic name. There's a couple of leading brands out there for that, but you know, they don't stop it occurring. They just help you deal with it when it happens. It doesn't stop your holiday being ruined. And you know, our biggest issue is getting people to know that this opportunity exists. And as pharmacies become aware of it, as you've seen in the August record sales, it's great for them. They get to bring more people into their stores. They sell more product, and they have customers that are happy. You know, recent reports on Amazon.com, yeah, we've got a 4.7 star rating, and it takes pleasure when I read some of the feedback from customers. You know, basically saying I had a event-free holiday, which is great. That's what we want.
What we all want. Excellent, Steve. Good to see you. Thanks for your time.
Yeah, thanks, Andrew.